So here we are at the Sage HR dashboard. Let's take a look around. On the top bar on the left, there is a search field. Here you can search for anything or anyone in Sage HR. On the right-hand side, the plus icon is a shortcut to the most common actions you are likely to need. On the top right-hand side, there is a link to your profile, settings and sign out. Here you can view and edit your profile, including uploading a photo. The settings tab is where you would make changes to settings or how things work throughout your Sage HR software. Here we are back at the dashboard. You can see all of the items you have for your attention on the dashboard widgets. The left-hand menu contains links to the features you have available to you in Sage HR, and this will be your primary source of navigation for everyday use. Also from the left-hand menu, when you select the Reports feature, the Reports menu opens, giving you access to all the reports for features that you selected at the beginning of your trial. The Help icon opens the Sage HR knowledge base in a new browser window. This is a fantastic resource for you to be aware of as you learn how to use Sage HR. Any questions you may have at this point are more than likely answered in the knowledge base. Down here in the bottom right of the screen, you can get help and find answers to any questions you may have. The help speech bubble icon is a helpful place with links to articles, the knowledge base, and online support. Take some time to get familiar with the Sage HR software while you have the trial. If you selected all of the Sage HR modules during the free trial setup, you will see all functionality. However, if you didn't select all of the modules, you'll not be able to see everything. Customers are able to ask for help with the green help button during the trial. Remember, the left-hand menu is where you process transactions. The settings menu is where you change settings within Sage HR.